Good evening. Welcome to Grandma's Attic Music Review. I have a sneeze coming on, so I'm trying to fight it. So Dipsy's in my lap. He's a good boy. He settles right down sometimes. Anyway, oh my goodness, have we got a show for you tonight? So sometimes when Terry LaChance sends me people, I get really excited and I reach out to them and I'm like, blah, 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 blah. And I got kind of shut down about this one because she was like, well, I'm off at school and blah, 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 blah. So she couldn't come do my show. And I was like, wow. But we had to wait. So I went way out on my calendar and booked her because I didn't want to lose the chance. You guys are going to have so much fun. She does original music. She's about this old. And she got her degree this last month. She got her bachelor's degree in music. Come on now. She's here to play for you. She's going to bring you the joy that just exudes from her. She's going to bring you her music, and she's going to bring you her smile. And I think you're going to enjoy all of it. Please help me welcome into your home and into your heart, Meggie.
Thursday, date with a boy I've never met, but he laughs a lot and he seems like a gentleman. Friday, turns out Olivia knows his ex, and that bodes well. She says she's as sweet as they get. We text her, send his bestie, says they're on good terms. She tells us, run away right now while I still can. Girl, he could be one of the ones if he wasn't such a jerk. Missing out on loving me because he screwed up loving her. So let's see what could happen if I let him live with it. So let's see.
Mentioned.
mentioned, I just graduated college a few weeks ago. Woohoo! Thank you. And I was majoring in music, minoring in English with a focus on creative writing, which is like the most singer-songwriter combo I could have possibly chosen. And last year, I had the privilege of studying abroad to Northern Ireland, where I got to study traditional Irish music, among many other things. So I was going out to pubs and listening to local bands, but also taking exams on this music. And my final project for one of my classes was to perform a few songs for my professor, which was so nerve-wracking, but so fun. So I wrote this next song while I was in Belfast and didn't intend for it to be taking any inspiration from that music, but I had been spending so much time with it that it just kind of seeped into my songwriting without me knowing. And one of the things that we were talking about in class is how in traditional Irish songs, expression and emotion is conveyed less through dynamics and tempos like it is in a lot of American music, and more through melodic variations and ornamentation. So normally I don't do a ton of ornamentation in my music, but in this song it started sneaking its way in and I just thought I would embrace it. So this is called She Doesn't Know. She doesn't think she'll ever find somebody to love her for a long time coming. I told her that I firmly disagree. She doesn't know she's already found me. She doesn't know I plan my days around taking walks after dark, leaving too late and talking too loud. Oh, she did a double take when I heard her say she doesn't think she'll ever find somebody to love her for a long time coming. Told her that
Woo!
Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo! Thank you. So I'm a firm believer that our culture needs to prioritize friendships a little bit more, and that romantic relationships often take a little bit more focus than they deserve in relation to friendships. So this is a song that I wrote. Many of my songs actually are trying to kind of uplift that and make friendships just as important as romantic relationships. And that means writing platonic love songs. And it also means writing platonic breakup songs. So this is one of those. It's called Movie. I didn't like you the first time we met. Thought you were fake, and to this day I swear it wasn't true yet. You had a knack for charming everyone, and we were fans of the same band, so how could anything go wrong? That's just how middle school goes. You pick a best friend before you know. 1 year later you were planning out the double wedding, buying a toothbrush with her name, keep it at your house for when she stays, teaches you to loosen up, and you teach her that she's enough. And then there's that movie we haven't finished yet. Forgot to see you all the fall, and at school you'd sit with kids who made me invisible. And I swore there was no drama, but tell me, why do you say you missed me? But you never called and you never texted, and you showed up late. You said my name like a child, like your child. That's just how friendships fade. Give a little time, a little space. You say hello on your way to class, but she says it wrong and it never lasts. She didn't mean it, but you still hurt. Telling you a secret, but she's bored. Defend her honor when anyone doubts. She's still good and you're still proud. And there's still that movie we haven't. Change, only grow. I know every word you meant, every lie you ever said. That's just how exes mend. Never strangers, never friends. If you need a place, you can spend the night. But please remember to brush this time. You've got other places to be. Thank you. How about a little Carly Simon? I bet you all know this song. You walked into the party like you were walking onto a yacht. Your hat strategically dipped below one eye. Your scarf in they'd be a partner and you're Because you never know how long it's going to take to write a song. I used to, in high school, I had so much homework, I would just make it a goal to write one song a week, and whether I liked it or not, I would just finish it by Sunday evening. And that worked in the sense that it kept me consistent, but you just never know how long a song is going to take. It could be 1 hour, and it could be a couple years. So I'm going to play a couple that had sort of unexpected paths. This one I wrote in a couple of days back in January, and I don't actually think it's done yet. I think there are some edits in its future, but I've been playing it out a couple of times, and it seems to really resonate with people, so I thought I'd play this little sneak peek of draft one of this song for you. It's called It's Not Hard. $2.29 and I bet you're not ready. Buzz me up anyway. Pull me to the bathroom sink. Let me watch you finish your face. Early enough between us that you still put on the glamour for me. Sure enough now that you let me in behind the scenes. And I feel you feeling like a burden. And I feel you wanting to apologize again. But it's not that hard to be the kind of girl you your bars and lean back, leave all the learning to me. Oh, let me work for your trust, let me prove your demons wrong. My exes all gave me something you can't, so you feel like you're holding me back. But if it's not you, babe, I don't want it. We have other ways we connect. Like when you play with my hair in front of our friends. Darling, let me remind you again.
to be the kind of girl you need. So raise your bars and lean back. Leave all the learning to me. People like us have been falling in love for centuries. They kept it quiet, I don't want to hide it. Show the kids what love can be. Cause it's not that hard to be the kind of girl you need. So raise your bar. And lean back, leave all the learning to me. Oh, let me work for your trust. Let me prove your demons wrong.
Thank you. So this next song also was a kind of weird journey writing it. I drafted it a couple of years ago, thought it was done, thought it was not quite up to snuff and would never see the light of day, and that was fine because just, you know, the way any creative practice goes, most of what you make is not gonna become a public thing. So I forgot about this song. And then life happened, new inspiration struck, and I, a couple months ago, had an idea for a completely different chorus and a couple other lines here and there. And once I realized that the chorus was the only thing I didn't like about the first draft, I just got rid of it, replaced it, and now I'm playing this out at like every gig. I love a good sassy song, so that's what this is. It's called Healing is Revenge. It was a compliment.
love was revenge.
Hoo-hoo!
Thank you. One more for now?
Sure.
Yeah? Beautiful. So, this past spring, my family and I went to Disney World, which is very exciting. I had only been one other time, and I was 6 years old, so we thought it would be a totally different experience than when I was 6 years old and wearing my princess dress. But as we were planning, we realized, no, it was going to be the same trip. My taste in rides, exactly the same. Still the only person in my family who likes roller coasters. Still the only person in my family who wants to get wet on a slide in the middle of the day. But it was really fun anyway. What we didn't anticipate is that the minute we got to Disney World, I had this feeling I needed to meet Rapunzel. I just suddenly was like, you know what, I'm 22, but I think I want to meet Rapunzel. I identify with her a little bit. I used to have really long hair. It was down to my knees till I was like 20. And the longer we were there, the more desperately I felt like I needed to find Rapunzel. So finally, it's the last day we're there. I've stopped playing it cool, and I'm like, Mom, can we go look for Rapunzel? So we go over to the place where all the princesses are hanging out. There's only gonna be two of them today, and she's one of them. So we're relieved, right? But then we get in line, and I'm suddenly so nervous. I lose all my confidence. I'm usually a very outgoing person, but not when I'm about to meet Rapunzel, apparently. I turned into this nervous little kid. I was all shy, and I was like, Mom, what do I do? It's Rapunzel. What do I say to her? Yeah, exactly. I was like, I have to be cool for Rapunzel. And my mom was looking at me like she didn't know what to do with me because she hadn't seen the side of me in years. So finally, we get up to the front of the line. Rapunzel starts talking to me about like frying pans and men with scary teeth. And I'm just like, cool, yeah, yes, got it. Thank you. We take a picture, I leave, and I burst into tears. It was so funny. I did not see that coming, but I was just so happy to meet her. But what I didn't get to tell her, since I was so nervous, is that I have a song called Rapunzel. And this is it. Understand now why Rapunzel trusted a man she'd never met. After all those years locked up in her tower, 'cause now I'm stuck here too. And the ground is down farther than it's been. But in hindsight,
just where I right now need to be. Thank you.
Oh my gosh. So if I could stand up and give you a standing ovation, I would right
but
now.
But you're clearly occupied.
Yeah. So come on over and have a seat. So while Meggie's coming over here and miking up and Dipsy's sound asleep, I'm a little blown away by what I just watched. So I hope you are too. There's so much going on. Think about your community and get out there and support live music, because live music is people like her. So spend the summer following live music, especially local live music, because we've got some of the most amazing musicians. Like 2 weeks from now, when we're back, we're gonna have a band called Gypsy Sun on. Yeah, yeah. Just put that in your pipe and smoke it for a couple of minutes. Let's talk to Meggie. Oh my gosh, girl. Oh my gosh, girl. So you're different.
Thank you.
You're not like everybody else. You're not like everybody else.
Thank you.
I'm a little emotional about it because I have a lot of people on my show. I do. Like every 2 weeks I've got two more people, and I have people that want to be on my show. And I have people that Terry sends me that want to be on my show. And I waited for you to come, and the video that I saw of you didn't even begin to exemplify who you are and what you do. There's so much depth in what you present to the audience. There's so much courage in the way you give of yourself so freely to hundreds and thousands of people. I have goosebumps. I really do.
Thank you.
Wow. I have good musicians on my show. And whenever I have good musicians and I tell them, I'm like, I don't say this to everybody, because I don't. But I'm saying to you, you wowed me.
Oh, thank you.
If I could clearly... Clearly my dog come first.
Oh no, I understand.
Over a standing O, but.
Thank you so much.
So, where can we, let's get people to know where to find you.
Sure.
Because people are gonna want more of you.
Well, thank you. First of all, thank you for having me. This is
absolutely
really, really
I've
cool.
waited for a long time.
Well, I'm glad it was worth it.
It was.
Yeah. Well, so I have lots of gigs around the area. My next gig is June 7th at the Hartford Taste Fest.
Okay.
I'll be playing at 2:45 p.m. on the Pratt Street stage.
I know where that is.
Yep.
That's
my next thing if people want to see me live. But yeah, I'm on Instagram.
That's Friday. Next, not this coming. You know what?
Yes.
You know what? It's already happened. It happened yesterday.
Oh, it's already yesterday.
Okay, well.
You guys missed
there's
it.
Plenty more.
Sorry, there's
plenty
more. There's a whole bunch more. Listen, she's going to tell us where we can find her more. Okay, yeah, go ahead.
So there's a bunch else happening. So the best way to stay up to date is my Instagram and my website. So everything is Meggie the Songwriter. That's M-E-G-G-I-E, the Songwriter.
Which you are.
Yep. So MeggieTheSongwriter.com has all my gigs listed. And then Instagram, hello, at Meggie the Songwriter. TikTok, Facebook, same thing.
Yep.
So I'll announce all the gigs as they come over there.
Okay, so you can find her on Meggie the Songwriter on all your platforms, all your social media platforms. Do it, because wow.
Thank you.
So your songwriting is inspired, obviously, about real feelings and real life events. I would be remiss if I didn't say it's very, how do I put this delicately? It's very female loving in its forms.
Mm-hmm.
And when I play this for my wife, she's gonna be like, oh, she's singing about us, right?
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And so many musicians that tend to have, and I'm gonna use one of my favorite words that nobody likes, that tend to have a queer aspect,
mm-hmm.
don't want people to see that.
Mm, yeah.
They don't want people to know who they love and why they love.
Right.
And I'm so proud of you. But when I was your age, I couldn't be that open.
Right.
It wasn't allowed. And when we wanted to walk down the street with our arms around each other's waists, we were shunned and put upon. And maybe it's the generation you're in right now, but you give old women like me, hope for the future. Oh, not just yeah. women, but men
right.
too, because so many people are out there and just want to love who they love. Love is love, it doesn't matter. So, and you write about platonic breakups. I love that.
Thank you.
I love that. I love that because I've had those.
Yeah.
I've had those.
And they're awful, right?
They're horrible. And you're not, in your song, I kind of got this thing that it was not really a breakup that, you didn't like say, I don't ever want to see you again, but you really didn't want to see that person anymore. I'm
mm-hmm.
done. I'm done. What makes you write a song like that? Just your feelings?
Yeah, I just think it's a topic that's really important for people to have something to turn to when that happens to them. You know, I played that out at a gig once, and someone about my age came up to me and said, hey, I'm going through something like that right now, and people don't understand a lot of the time how much that hurts because it happens gradually. No one, usually, you don't have one
right.
big fight and it's over.
Right. Not when you're just friends.
Exactly.
You have a fight
right.
and then you make up because you don't want to lose the friendship.
Exactly.
And you stay together as friends because who breaks up with their friend?
Right, exactly.
Right.
And so I think it's just one of those things that so many people go through, and it's really important that people have something to turn to. So much like with the queer representation that I'm doing, like I think that's another important aspect of representation that I can offer, you know, blending my own life with my friends' lives and other stories I hear about to just sort of create something people can turn to.
So there are women out there that are singing lesbian songs. There
right.
are. And they have their niche. And they're mostly followed by women that love women.
Mm-hmm.
I don't see in your music that happening. I see people connecting with, not that your songs are generic, because by no stretch of the imagination is there anything that I would put to your songs called generic. I think you're very bold and very real.
Thank you.
But because of that, I believe that everybody that hears you sing is going to want more.
Mm.
You have a richness of voice, a richness of character that, like I said, it just exudes from you. It's really amazing. When you're trying to write a song, are you still writing a song a week? Or was back in the day?
That was back in high school when it was like I needed a steady goal in order to write anything at all because I was so busy. And now, like, I just did 4 years of college studying music, so there was a lot of...
You're preaching to the choir, girl.
Right, yeah. So there was a lot of crossover between songwriting and what I was doing for homework, which was really nice. But now I'm doing music as full-time as possible, basically. Mm-hmm. So I'm figuring out the next, like, what's my next weekly goal? I think it's going to be more about how much time I spend on songwriting rather than how much I actually produce, because I think that's just a more... productive, healthy way to think about creativity.
Yep.
But it's really interesting. I every summer I spend a couple weeks writing a song every day, and that's like it's what I call my songwriting streak. And usually most of them are awful. But the last couple of times I've done that, I've started to write songs that I'll actually keep afterwards. So that's been really rewarding, and I might do a little more of that.
I think that it's like baking. Once you learn the recipe.
Exactly.
And know how to make it your own, it becomes yours and easier to do. I just lost my question. Oh, how do your parents feel about your music?
They like it. They're really supportive, which is awesome. They've been driving me to open mics since I was 15.
Nice.
So I really, I wouldn't have been able to start as a teenager if they hadn't been driving me around and standing with me in bars and
making sure
that it was okay for me to be there. So they're great about it.
That's awesome. That's awesome. And when your mother heard you sing a song about another woman, mm-hmm. what did she say to you?
I don't know if she said anything. I don't even know if I was like, I don't really know if I came out. You know, I think it just, I think I just was never hiding it. And which is really special that I was able to do that, and so I think she just clapped like, great song, honey.
Some people just know.
Yeah, that's possible.
So that's,
too.
So that's good. Now, what do you have going on for recording?
Great question. Yeah. So I have three songs.
Well, yeah.
I have three songs that are already out right now on Spotify and Apple Music and all of those places. So. They're all available just under my name, Meggie, no last name. And then next up, I'm actually in the next few days figuring out my kind of timeline for what the next song is going to be. I don't want to say for sure what it is, but I think it's going to be one of the ones that I played today.
They're all great.
Thank you. Yeah, I'm really, really excited. And I love producing as well as the writing part. So
usually when people put out an album, you get the album, if there are even three songs on a 10 to 12 song album that are good, then it's a good album. You just did 35 minutes of great music.
Thank you.
There wasn't a song, not even Carly Simon's song, would I have cut off an album. I wouldn't have taken one of those songs off an album. So I've had maybe in my career, I want to say maybe two or three albums come my way where I've said, there's not a bad cut on this.
Wow.
So when you put your album out, because you're gonna, Dipsy
honestly, doesn't like my set list.
Dipsy is eating the set list.
I
don't think he's eating it because he didn't like it. I think he's eating it because he wants more.
Like, ooh, tasty set.
So after we finish taping, I'm going to book you to come on the radio show.
Okay, amazing.
And I want you to stay in touch because I want to follow your stuff. I think that you have what it takes. Wait. I think you have what it takes. I don't think everybody will love your music, but everybody doesn't love everybody's music.
Of course.
People ask me, what's your favorite kind of music? I'm like, it's easier for you to ask me what I don't like than because I'm so eclectic in what I like for music. But I think that more people will like you than don't
Thank
like you.
You.
You won't be everybody's cup of tea.
No, never.
But you'll be certainly everybody's water. Because you're a long, cool drink of refresh. Yeah. And I think, right? See? So it's a real thing. Your music was refreshing and filling. There's so much that I want to chew on with your music. Why do you think that you write the way that you do? Because you don't have anybody else's form. Like, who do you think you might take after?
I think, so both of my parents are English teachers.
Oh, well, there sort you go.
So I grew up with every piece of media being analyzed in real time. So like we watch a movie and while the credits roll, the writing is being talked about. So I think I tend to do that with music. I listen to something, have at it. I listen to a new song and I'm usually kind of trying to pick apart what I like about it. So that's why I think I take influence from a lot of different things that I listen to, but I'm a huge Swiftie, which a lot of people I think can hear. And I also love, I don't know if you've heard of Maisie Peters.
Yep.
Yeah, she's amazing. Love her writing. Boy Genius, I don't know if you know them.
Nope.
Phoebe Bridgers is one, it's a trio. Phoebe Bridgers, Lucy Dacus, Julian Baker. They're amazing. Those are probably my top few right now who I take inspiration from.
I don't think you're anything like Taylor Swift.
Oh, thank you.
I'm not a fan. Not a big fan. But then I'm not a big fan of pop girls in general because I find mm-hmm. they've all put themselves into one box.
Oh, interesting.
They all sound alike. They all sing about the same shit, and they don't go past that.
Mm.
And you just broke that mold because you're nothing like them. And I, yeah. So
well,
anyway,
thank you.
I'm sorry that I'm gushy. I'm gushy. Sorry. I can't wait to play your music for my wife. I can't. And she's going to be like, wow. And her and I have totally different tastes in music. Like we don't like the same music at all. She's a generation behind me musically. Mm-hmm. You know,
okay.
I'm almost 10 years older than she is. And her music is that 10 years
right.
later. Like the hip hop and stuff, and she really likes that stuff.
Yeah.
And I really like it's okay, but it's not my favorite.
There you go.
So anyway, I can't wait.
Well, thank
Do you have a song to take us out with?
I do, yeah.
I'm so excited. And then don't take off after that. Dipsy tore up your set list.
I know. That's okay. We don't need it anymore.
But go play us a song.
All right.
So I'm sorry if I was a little... You guys that watch my show every week, Tim, I know you're out there watching this show. I know you are. You know that I don't get gushy about every musician on the show. You know I don't. I like people. I think people are great. But this was different, wasn't it? Wasn't it amazing? So thank you all for tuning in to Grandma's Attic Music Review. I hope you will go check out Meggie's music. I hope you'll check out all the musicians that come on my show. Go check this stuff out. It's all on YouTube. If you miss something, go back. You can check it out. And do me a favor. Get out there and take care of your community. Spend your money in your community, and the money will stay in your community, okay? All right? Okay? Let's let Meggie take out the show. Bye for now.
This is my latest single. You can find it on Spotify and Apple Music and all of those places. It's called Epilogue. Thank God It Was You. Saw you creeping on my Instagram. Sweet of you to wonder how I am. Took me back to when we were kids, and I dare to remember this. Back when I thought I'd find the perfect definition for love with some time. You were the kid in the band at school, and suddenly all my friends knew you. Walking to the lake in the mud, everyone stealing phones trying to set us up. Took a blind leap and landed somewhere. Thank you for having me. Oh, thank you.